I'm not actually here to watch a film, I'm here to project it. I'm going to go to work, I've laced up everything else in the building, all the right screens. Just going to go and lace up 7, which is Titanic, and that's playing in 70mm. Now, 70mm is a more expensive format, and greater care is needed when handling it and lacing it up. But the difference is that down here, on the screen, the image is that much sharper, particularly if it was originated or if it was shot on 70mm. In this particular case, the Titanic was shot on 35mm or Super 35, and then blown up to the larger 70mm format. So, why are we showing Titanic in 70mm? Well, two things. 70mm used to be used quite a lot on the old Hollywood epics. There's a prestige to the format, probably more so nowadays, because it's quite rare, it's not used so much. So in answer to that question, it's probably a combination of the two things. And Titanic is an epic film. It's considered by some to be quite a large film, so it seems appropriate that it should be shown in this format. So, let's get the ship ready to sail and get it laced up. Okay, I'll see you later. You see here the size difference between the 70mm print and the 35mm backup. In fact, if we go over to the bench, if we look at this black leader, we can see the size difference even more clearly. This is the 70mm, this is the 35. The 70mm, as you can see, has a frame area of more than twice that of the 35mm. And its other main difference is the fact that 35mm has 4 perforations, 1, 2, 3, 4 per frame, and 70mm has 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, it's almost time. The film's laced up, it's ready to go, it's been checked, so it's time to press the start button.